Basis of scientific research, lecture 5, the theme, research organization. So, the first, keeping your research organized. In order to keep it, you begin to assemble your research. It's imperative to keep your notes centrally located and easily accessible. You might want to create a binder to keep all your papers and notes together, or dedicate a multi-sectioned notebook to your research. You might take notes on note cards, organize them by color or heading. If you take your notes online, you can use cloud computing to store your research remotely, to access them anywhere on the go. Other software exists to keep your notes files and organized electronically on your computer. Always keep records of where you got your information. You'll need this in case someone ever decides to question you about the facts after your speech. Also, this shows people that yes, you've done your homework. Then, however you organize your notes, just make sure you have them organized and handy. You never know what you might run into primary source. All speeches must have a point or a main argument, a thesis. Develop it. The thesis statement in any opinion piece, spoken or written, the main argument is the thesis statement, and it comes at the beginning. You want your audience to know always the point of you are trying to make, and it's important to remember that your thesis statement only addresses the main issue, the ways in which you choose to support your thesis, and complexity and depth of your speech. When composing your thesis statement, consider and answer the following question. How do you feel about your topic? How does your audience generally feel about it? What do you want your audience to feel or believe? What other opinions have been said? Are you arguing or against your topic? What social issues factor into your topic? And what is your topic influence on the individual? As you begin to answer these questions, start thinking about ways you want to support your thesis with compelling, persuasive examples. And supporting your ideas. Once you have solidified your position on your thesis statement, you want to back up your thesis with a variety of supporting ideas and examples. So the first set the stage. Using exposition in a great way to get your audience all the same playing field. And when you use an expository approach, you are carefully laying out all the background information your audience needs to know in order to understand your point. Appeal to commonalities. As you notice commonalities between audience members, the audience of your and your topic, you and your audience appeal to those commonalities, not only establish rapport, but also to more easily persuade them to your thesis and claims. Your audience is more likely to trust and believe you if you feel they share something in common with you and your topic. Organizing and outlining the speech. Key points. So, to organize your thoughts, consider giving each point or supporting evidence its own note card. Begin to arrange them according to importance, and your main points will begin to emerge. Outlines typically begin with your thesis and end with any concluding thoughts. Depending on your topic or thesis, arranging your points chronologically is an effective way to establish a timeline of your argument. In giving you informational speech, you might describe your subject as parts of an object, outlining each part of a section. And you can move from bullet points to specific points or vice versa, depending on the effect you are trying to achieve and the arguments you are trying to make. Appeal to commonalities. As you notice between audience, the audience and your topic, and find a consensus. Your audience may already feel a certain way about your topic. Depending on you are trying to argue, you may want to go ahead and appeal to that consensus. Just be careful. You don't want to bore your audience by preaching to the choir. So there is an example of outline all about issues of feminism in William Shakespeare's Hamlet. So key points. Use the ABC approach to begin your first draft. An abstract explain your thesis. The body features your main points and supporting evidence. The conclusion contains your final thoughts and reiterates your point. Make sure you have all your notes and research close by and easily accessible so you can turn to your sources as often as you need to while you draft your speech. Editing and revising are not the same thing. To edit, review your speech for changes. To revise, actually internet those changes. Editing and revising are in nature as you continue a whole new draft. In your first draft, you find yourself going on a tangent. Allow yourself to follow it. You can also edit, revise, and remove sections later that were off topic. Writer's block can happen to even the best writers. Take a break for a few minutes and come back to a speech renewed and refreshed. But don't stay away too long, or you might lose your momentum. So, key points: eloquence, abstract, writer's block. Writing your first draft. Refine, refine, refine. Editing and revising. Now, what that you have written the first draft, reread what you have written, refine your wording. Editing. Read your first draft and look for typos such as spelling and grammatical errors. Consider the vocabulary you are using, and it is helpful to give your first draft to another person to review and edit, as it helps to have a fresh eye look at your material. And revising. Once edits have been made, implement those suggestions and changes to a draft. Then you begin revising, you may find that you are making more changes about the way and may write multiple drafts. The editing and revising process becomes a cycle of newer drafts. Eventually, the revisions will be done and you will have settled on your final draft. Preparing to present. Reading your speech word for word, memorizing your speech, speaking extemporaneously from notes, dealing with nerves, and delivering the speech. Details like those how you dress, enunciate, and use body language can be just as important as what to say. Make sure you dress to impress and engage your audience by making eye contact with them. In making eye contact, you can always look just above their heads to give the same effect. Stand up straight and limit your interjections. Avoid slangs or profanity. Have a backup plan in case equipment fails for things such as a valid visual aids, PowerPoint presentation, or anything else. As for end key points, body language. Body language consists of body posture, breath, gestures, facial expressions, eye movements, etc. And the following literature and uses from internet will help you to prepare for the seminar.